valve cover bolts that were left loose and or missing, fuel injector rail bolts that were left loose, brake booster vacuum line that was left loose, another vacuum line that was left loose, timing cover bolt that was found just as it is, missing timing cover bolt, missing oil pan bolt, as well as an oil leak in it. The starter I have in video where it was also left loose. Both of the bolts were in it, but it was not tight. And I'm going to start taking off the valve cover and the timing cover to find out why this engine failed. I did also find that it has a new head gasket. If you see right there, that is the corner from a brand new head gasket. So, start taking it apart. For the dipstick, the engine is completely full of oil when the engine failed. Is obvious signs of sludge in the top of the cylinder head, which would not be normal if the head had been removed and properly sent to a machine shop to have it resurfaced and cleaned, valves checked, and or sealed or resealed. Remove the water pump pulley to gain access to the belt tensioner bracket. Go ahead to get to the timing cover.
balancer. Balancer bolts are usually extremely tight if they've never been removed. There is obvious signs that the timing cover was removed. And silicone back with what appears to be gray Permatex silicone. Timing cover. Remove the one bolt that is in the bottom of the oil pan. It goes to the timing cover. And a corner here on the block is actually broke, and it was glued back in with Permatex to hide that it was broken off. Actually, if you look, there's also a bolt here that is missing out of the water pump. Remove the timing cover, give it a couple little taps. Again, full of sludge inside. I'm going to rotate the crank to orientate it for top dead center to confirm cam and crank correlation. As you see, the gray silicone, very heavily installed. With the removal of a cylinder head, both of these guides, the guide and the tensioner, should have been replaced. And they were not. One more time for the correct orientation.
As you can see, the triangle is lined up with the triangle there. Get a little bit straighter. Should be dead even. And this mark and this mark show that it is in fact in time.
All the gray that is in this oil,
the oil out,
is all engine bearing material. As you can see, still draining out of the motor. The oil is drained now, so now I'm going to move on to removing the bracketry and anything getting in the way of taking the pan off.
Thank you.
pan was glued on with gray Permatex silicone as well. Glued to the point that every bolt is out and it's still not coming loose. There we see a bunch of bearing material. Even the grayness in the oil is metal. That is all metal chunks of bearing from the bottom end. Exactly which rods it is.
Now, we have a windage tray in the way.
Get that out of the way first.
Out of the windage tray. From looking, I don't see any hot spots, so it didn't get super hot. We can see where there was the old brown factory Honda silicone. Then we can see on the edge, the gray silicone, which was added after the fact. Put the camera back in. Alright. So, number two. A little bit of movement. Number three, tight as can be. Where's the ratchet? There it is. Rotate it around. Number one. No bearing at all left in it. Number four. Tight as can be. So cylinders one and two.
I believe it was. I said it was two. Was the other one that was loose?
Yep, one and two. Two is not nearly as bad as number one.